Liebe Hexen, liebe Hacker, liebe Entitäten, liebe Wesen. Hier ist der erste Hamburger Fernstream mit der Tagesshow.
This is the first Hamburg Livestream with the Daily News. Everything's down.
Die Supermärkte sind leer und das Internet ist noch.
And Internet is bad as ever. Germany is sinking in chaos. This or similar news could be in the future. So there's the question: how can we prepare on that? And maybe it's enough what we already have. So how should we prepare? Should we throw out of our houses the cars and bunker toilet paper? Or should we just do nothing? In the next talk, Peter N2N and Hase and Kritis are talking about this topic.
Peter
N2N. He's working on civil protection services for a few years, and the other speaker is co-founder of the AG Kritis. Both are sending live from North Rhine-Westphalia. Kritis, name is program. He is working at civil protection and catastrophe protection for a few years. And he's standing there with a lot of distance to me here in Hamburg. And now he gives his talk, how nerds survive when pizza.de is down.
Viel Spaß.
So, welcome to this translation. Today, translating for you this talk from German to English is Katzenzunge and Bread and Toast. Now, let's start. So, what shall we do when everything's really getting ugly and nothing is working as we used to?
Einige Bundesländer haben den Begriff der Katastrophe aus ihrem
Some gestrichen. States in Germany just threw out the topic of catastrophes from their laws.
Läuft alles? Wunderbar.
And they just modified their laws and said, no, we don't know about catastrophes. They don't happen here. But if you're doing it on your own, there are a few ways you can do it on your own. I want to ask you to just scan this QR code or have a look on the site of the Bundesamt für Katastrophenschutz. There you can download this advisor, and you should print them out in advance, because if you want to get it when things went bad and you're not prepared, when energy is gone, then there's a shutdown, then maybe you don't get it anymore. So catastrophes mostly won't stop at the state border. Therefore, actually at the borders, we have corporations. And what we call emergency services, it's basically a lot of agencies working together. And they are working over cities and over states, even over the whole country together.
Und den
Times there were special forces for this, but not now anymore. And this is somehow divided from civil protection when there is war. And they work from a perspective of priority. So therefore, it's important that we prepare ourselves. So I'll tell you how can we prepare ourselves in general and then later on for more specific points. So specific points I won't touch today. So let's have a scenario where we have a power shortage. And power shortages will have an extreme impact. We may know this when there was snow in the 80s meters high and we had to go through the countries by skiing. And besides not being locked in the houses,
Münsterland, viele Bauern mussten versorgt werden mit Strom oder
then we had problems like the milking machines at the farms won't work anymore and a lot of things.
Man kann auch sehr unverschuldet reinkommen. Wir alle haben vielleicht noch Erinnerung den die Abschaltung.
Some might remember to switch off the high voltage lines.
Hervorgerufen, der bis nach Spanien runter.
So, without electricity, there are no walls.
Und statt dass dieser große Sektor Strom, an dem alles hängt, betroffen ist,
apart from betroffen sein, this large sector of electricity being affected, other sectors might also be affected, such as banking,
die Ölkrise damals,
water supply, oil crisis,
oder was eine Überraschung.
And a pandemic could also hit us. What a surprise.
Und für die jetzt auch mal her zum normalen zurückkommen. Genau an der Stelle.
And this is the point where a lot of problems can occur.
Vielen Stellen in der in unserem Ablauf
which
einfach
would have detrimental effects on our normal ways of doing things. So one important thing is of course water.
Und, hat Peter uns einmal zusammengestellt, wie wir uns
so Peter has vorbereiten können. Brought us a summary how we can prepare in this particular area.
Peter, magst du dich unmuten?
Danke. So, wir gehen davon aus, wir haben schlagartig.
We're assuming that all of a sudden we don't have water anymore in the household.
In Deutschland oftmals das Glück, das passiert mit
in Germany, this usually happens with some advance notice, and we can fill up all everything that we have: the bathtub, pots, bottles, etc. If we do not have this possibility, we need to rely on what we have stocked up, and this, depending on, can be very little. So we usually need at least 2 liters per person per day. In case of disaster, we should be prepared for 10 days. So assuming that 10 days, there will be no fresh drinking water.
Wenn wir Glück hatten und es kündigt sich an, dass wir
if we are lucky and there has been an advance notice, for instance, storm warning, then please do make sure that you fill up everything that you have, all
es wird auch
containers.
Die Zeit, wenn der Katastrophenschutz dann da ist, also die Leute, die das professionell machen.
So, this gives the professionals some time to activate some welds, and if this happens, there might be a long queue, people queuing up with containers to fill up. This is a 10-liter canister.
Das 9 Liter kann man sich vorstellen, das sind die Das ist der große Sixpack mit den 1,5 Liter Flaschen,
die man kennt. 1.5 Liter Bottles, you should be able to carry this from one place to the other.
Das ist natürlich einfacher an der Wasserstelle als
and this is of course easier with one canister instead of multiple bottles.
Generell müssen wir mit diesem kostbaren
in general, we should be very economic with das this valuable and essential water supply. So no washing dishes.
Auch im Zweifel, wenn wir kein Einweggeschirr haben, nehmen wir Frischhaltefolie und bedecken dann unsere Teller.
We might have to use some foil, cling film to cover our plates.
Das heißt kein Baden,
no showering,
sondern der altbewährte.
Just use cloth for washing.
Nicht die Hygiene, weil sonst
but we should not neglect hygiene, because this could then lead to other problems.
Das Problem ist, wenn wir sagen, 10 Tage
say,
Wasser
und 10 days of water supply,
die Wanne,
so,
das Klowasser, die Töpfe ist das
für bathtub, and parts for cooking,
dann müssen wir das trotzdem irgendwann entkeimen, weil je länger das
Wasser
steht, desto mehr
remove bacteria from that, disinfect everything.
Das, was wir als Keime kennen, das können Sedimente sein, das können Viren und Bakterien sein,
viruses, bacteria, sediments, microorganisms, and then the water is not usable anymore.
Man sieht das mit der Zeit auch. Man
after a while you can see it and smell it,
in dem Zustand, wenn man
but it's also dangerous when you don't see or smell
das
anything.
Das Erste, was wir machen können, ist, wenn wir Wasser haben, wo wir nicht ganz sicher sind,
so when we have water where we are not quite sure if this is suitable or not, then we can use a coffee filter.
Damit einmal durchfiltern lassen.
We just pass the water through the filter to remove the largest sediments or small animals, insects.
Wer das Ganze in größer
if we have, if you'd like to use something that's a bit larger or more professional,
Teichbesitzer kennen das, einen so, großen
so
Eimer,
this is a pond filter,
natürlich dann richtig Masse durch,
which
und das
has a lot of capacity to pass through water,
but
if you have one of those, this works really well, but you don't need to get one especially for that.
Auch jemand, der
also, an ultraviolet lamp,
der funktioniert
this works also if you have one of those at home.
Teich- und Aquarienbesitzer haben mehr davon. Was es gibt, viel im Campinghandel oder halt
camping supplies or other professional shops, you have sanitization tablets such as chlorine, active coal, every camping shop has these things, outdoor shop, so you can get some of those.
Generell ist es in Deutschland aber so, wir haben eine recht gute Wasserqualität. Das
general,
ist Fall, gerade wenn
in Germany we have a really high quality of water, so this is really good for the disaster case.
Alles, was irgendwie Alge oder Mikroorganismus ist, denkt sich, juhu, Pedel! Und dann wird das Wasser.
The water also goes bad easily when there's a lot of light or brightness.
Eine kleine Sache, die man machen kann, die kann jeder Haushalt machen, und das ist abkochen. Filtern und dann abkochen.
The one thing every one of you can do is cook your water and then filter your water. That's a great idea. So you can cook with cooked water. You also can brush your teeth with cooked water, because otherwise you might get sick. And then you might have dry food. And now I'm giving to the next speaker, who is telling you something about food. So I'm telling you something about the normal mode in the beginning. So the BBK in their notice give you a short notice, a personal checklist, where they tell you which kind of food and drinks you actually need. And I don't want to bore you with it, but for one person over 10 days, you have lots of food with nuts and milk and rice and stuff. So you could prepare this with canned food. But the one or other of you would say, I don't have the space and I can't store it. And the thing which I found as an alternative are these survival biscuits. They also called it tank cookies. They are very small, don't take that much space, and can be easily stored. Or these Energy 5 bars you could buy.
Wenn man eine NGO ist, die anerkannt ist, kann man die sogar
There are possibilities to get them on the cheap, but otherwise, yeah, there are small portions in there. In general, 9 bars are inside one pack, and 1 bar is 1 meal. The interesting thing about it is that if you have cooked water, you can put this special bar here into water and have something like what also is pretty easy to be done are called EPAs. They are one person rations. It's the question if you like them, but they easily can be stored. The checklist from BBK also tells you some things, gives you advice, and the question you have is, do you like it? If you like it, then you buy one and have a bit more of it. If you don't, then you should not. I couldn't advise you this, but I use this cookies, and what I really like is Chinese noodle soup and canned food. I have them with me, for instance, at the hacker camps, and who has kids now, they really like ravioli, canned raviolis, so they are actually easy to prepare. And what you should do is you should try to consume what you stored for the emergency case, so, and then buy them refill stocks so that you have a rolling supply. We also have a small garden where we have fruit trees, and this can I have done on my own, and these can also be stored for a long time. About storage is very important. Everything needs to be closed, and some things like water shouldn't get a lot of light. And if you have something like fur, then it should be in reusable but airtight casings. And if you have a vacuum machine, then you can use this, and it might help you to increase storage time. So there are also really people who might make their pizzas fresh, even in emergency case, but it's not for everyone, and for me that's enough on food right now. Okay, the small patch from Cert, you know, and you get it if you need it here, but there are some things that you don't get. For instance, some people who need medicine at the Congress come to us and say, oh, I've forgotten my medicine, and it's very important. So not just from Congress, but in all ways, you know, it's really important to have a bit of your medicine on store if you're really dependent on it. Very important is also to have the best before date on your blisters. Because if you cut the pieces, then it might be that the best before date is not on the piece you cut off. So therefore, you should at least with waterproof pens note it on them.
immer gucken, was man selber auch gebrauchen kann.
Also you should look for what you actually like need over time. For instance, I need a tick removal because I get ticks from time to time. The cert has for all hackerspaces a list for emergency kits for hackerspaces. So if you are looking for it, look there. Right now, it would be important to have a mask. For instance, if you have to live in a community shelter, then you might want to have on the second day a second mask. So what also not might be very wrong is
man darauf vorbereitet ist, dass es Bedürfnisse gibt, die einen selber nicht unbedingt betreffen, aber
that you are maybe prepared for having stuff with you which what's a need for someone else.
Der nächste Punkt auf dem Inhaltsverzeichnis wäre wichtige Dokumente griffbereit halten. Viele Dokumente muss man
One important point would be to have documents with you, copies of important documents, or have them prepared in such a way that when you leave your place of residence, that you can have the documents quickly with you, for instance, when there's a bomb threat, which usually comes really sudden. So, for instance, you could have a fire breakout in your neighboring house when the Christmas tree catches fire because of a stupid cat, then it's really important to be able to quickly leave your house with all these important documents. This is also in the checklist. Ideally, they are all already in a bag or backpack. Important is, of course, some ID document, some money, cash,
im Zweifelsfall
pictures of your family. It might be the case that you can't access Facebook anymore or other media, so you need to have pictures.
In dem Schnellzugriff Bereich hat.
This should all be quickly accessible.
Auch wenn ihr ein Backup dabei habt von euren wichtigsten.
Would also be good to have a laptop with all your important data, which you can store as an encrypted archive.
Zugangsdaten sehr sehr gut merken und
Und natürlich offline or online. You can store them on a USB key or a hard drive, which is also a great idea.
Ja, und
how to transport this? Well, Peter has prepared something for that.
Ja, bei mir geht's jetzt erstmal wieder um. Ja.
So, how to pack my backpack?
Jetzt geht's drum.
Which kind of backpack? We all have one of these things at home. This is not enough.
Das reicht nicht.
And if you look at it, there's no padding, this is not very comfortable, it's badly adjusted, not really ideal. So, other people might say, well, I have one of these camping backpacks, this has enhancements, but this is quite heavy and bulky, especially when it's full of things.
Mir ist der hier
so for me this would be too large.
Der muss auf den Menschen selber passen. Der ist
needs to fit well to the person.
Der hat den Beckengurt, was toll ist. Mir ist er zu groß, das heißt bei mir
so for me this wouldn't work because it's too large.
Ich bin nach einem halben Tag so weit, dass ich ausfalle.
I wouldn't be able to carry this anymore after half a day or so.
Das heißt für mich
so for me smaller one would be better.
Wo ich dann halt im Zweifel
where I can attach other things if needed. So you need to check yourself what is suitable for you and also for children. I mean, these can be smaller backpacks, but at least the favorite pet animal is with them.
Und dann ist es natürlich so ein gerade bei Kindern
packen
ihren Sonderbedarf im Zweifel selber drin.
Children, they should pack their own special things. What should I pack into my own backpack?
Das kann man unter ein großes Wort packen.
So the main term here is protection. Protection for or against what? Cold.
Handschuhe.
So gloves.
Klamotten, also
clothes. A jacket. leather jacket, solid boots, no shoes, and warm clothes.
Und zwar solche Sachen, die ich auch einen zweiten und einen dritten Tag.
Should be possible to wear them 2 or 3 days in a row because they will become monkey, and that's the way it is in a disaster case. It should be waterproof as well.
Mein Schuhwerk.
Also the boots should be waterproof.
Man kann auch über Gummistiefel nachdenken, gerade wenn man
Wallis might be an option.
Es gibt auch Menschen, die können das nicht. Da dann
or at least proper hiking boots.
Dann Schutz
and protection against hunger. So
we've
spoken about supplies and water.
Das heißt aber auch so etwas wie
this also means dishes, camping so dishes.
Ganz kleine Variante davon.
Maybe even
Wärme zu kriegen,
some sort of heat.
Kann. Die Thermoskanne ist ein super Hilfswerk, weil selbst wenn ich selber nicht kochen kann, irgendwo heißes Wasser.
Hot water, storage possibilities.
Dosenöffner ist was ganz Tolles.
Tin opener, easily forgotten. If you're good, you have one on your penknife.
Mit so einem Dosenöffner muss man umgehen.
But of course, you also need to be able to operate this can opener. This is different from the one that you have in your kitchen. So you need to practice this. In a state of emergency, you don't have the time to start practicing, so you need to be able to work with this, which isn't easy. So, protection against the dark, a lamp.
Lampe, ob das jetzt die Taschenlampe so, oder die Stirnlampe ist.
Pocket lamp, the one that you can wear on your forehead, something like that.
In die Richtung dabei. Und nicht
and
vergessen, Feuer machen, gerade wenn man das Geschirr dabei hat.
Lighter, so that you can make fire.
Ob man das jetzt noch erweitert auf, ich habe auch
so you can extend this of course
im Rucksack, nein, zu Hause.
You might have things at home like candles, but you don't need to put them into the backpack. You might have them at home.
Das große, wovor man sich noch schützen muss, ist natürlich.
You also need to protect yourself, of course, against injury. This is really important.
Das wollt ihr alles nicht.
You don't want this on top of the general state of emergency.
Wir haben zur ersten Hilfe gehört.
We've heard something about the emergency pack, first aid kit. So all of this you need to have with you. You need to have a corona mask with you, at the moment at least. Because we don't want to get sick. There are a few important things. You need to protect the hands, because you need them. So if you have gloves, they should be not only warm, but robust. Because you don't want to injure your hands in a situation like that. And the socks and
Unterbuchse ist nicht nur bei Männern unangenehm. Dadurch, dass ihr die im Zweifel auch mal einen Tag mehr
underwear is also important for men and women, of course. You need to make sure it wears comfortably.
Das ist ganz bäh. Deshalb gut sitzende. Im Zweifel die Schießer Feinrippware, die muss nicht sexy sein.
Doesn't have to be sexy, of course, it just needs to be well comfortable.
Bei mir sind das tatsächlich welche, die in
so my socks have padding inside.
Das ist man
might be the case that you have to walk all day and you might not be used to this. If the shoes and socks are not well worn in, then your feet will hurt. And this is something you don't want to have to deal with. A final remark, protection against injuries, protect your teeth. Protect your teeth because this is really important. What you don't want is having a toothache. Doesn't matter, you don't want this in this kind of situation.
Okay, so, and what's above it all are my documents. Maybe a camera, so I can document what's happening. And that's what's inside my backpack. So now we are going on. With wooden handy. Yeah, thanks. We also have the necessity to prepare. For instance, preparing for not having any communication. So what I have at the camp already is this solar cell. It's not very big, but it is possible to charge my smartphone with it. Because there's, for instance, the app Nina, where you get a few information from the BBK. But problem is, this for the solar cell, you need sun. But from camp, you know, there is not always sun. So you should have something like a power bank, so that you can charge your devices when there's no sun for your solar cell. I have one with four power outlets, so I can charge four devices at once, because I know that at some point in time I need this or needed this. So then we have radio and light. This light is running with mono cells, and mostly I store the double A batteries, and this is an adapter where I can put in these double A batteries to fit in bigger battery slots. So this is making me preparing much more easy, because I have to store one type of battery. If you then have a power bank or solar cell, and we would work with these lithium batteries, they are a bit bigger, and you know maybe the problem, this lithium battery size is not that easy to get, especially in case of emergency. So it's also very expensive to have a lot of them. I don't want to tell you that the common ones are more are better, but I want to tell you that you have to think about what's better for you. And I tell you there are these options, and then you have to choose. If you don't want to have that kind of simple radio, you might also buy the extremely fancy emergency radio variant, where you can use this knob to generate power for the radio. But if you have to work for 1 minute to have 10 minutes radio, it's maybe a bit nasty, but it's a nice gadget to have.
Und auch für die Solarzelle ein Ladegerät.
I have a radio and a charger for my double A batteries. So, but why do you need a radio? Well, because at some point there might be emergency fountains where you get water. So, and you might not know where they are. So with your radio receiver, you might be able to get that information. Most likely it's the public radio stations. Here in Northern Germany it's the NDR, but whatever is in your region, and they give you the information. Also, what's practical and important.
Und dafür würde ich mal sagen, Honkase, it's your turn.
Jo, wir haben ja gesagt, der Ratgeber ist das Nonplusultra, weil das BBK das sehr gut erklärt hat, da drin, was man so braucht. Es sind
okay. So there is, here is the information from the BBK. There also is information for children with nice pictures and a bit of a few games for them to play. Also in there is this checklist. If you open it, it's a bit bigger, a bit longer. The idea behind it is that you have the things we talked about here on your own, and you can tick a box there, so you're sure you're prepared. So there's a lot of in there which might not be relevant to you, but other things might be missing, so you can modify this for you and you should have some thoughts in advance and then being prepared in such a moment. For instance, when there's a power shortage and I need a candle and fire starter, then I have to know where they are and not say, oh, I haven't bought them. So, what's important, this checklist is a good basis. It should just be used as a basis for you, but in case something happens, then you have a solid foundation. It just needs to be end of world, but in some way, something might happen. We know this from the cyber world, something might happen, and the point is, the better you're prepared, the better you're off, and you should be prepared before. So in this way, you are not driven by the situation, and notice that maybe you're too late, or something else, like filling all your bottles in last minute. One can tell oneself that, okay, that's fine and it's not happening to me, or that I might be prepared. But no, it's not the case. You should have some preparation for emergencies. Someone shows an older version of it in the preparation to this talk. And this checklist, it's got hung up. You can build on it. In the next years, there might be an update to this because everything's developing. If you look, in what's happened in the emergency catastrophe winters in the 70s and 80s, the world wasn't digitalized like we are now. So today we are much more dependent on it. So this checklist and your necessities, what you need, will change over time. And obviously you have to adapt to new situations and new needs. So, but coming back to the time where you prepare, either you let the situation drive you, or in advance you say, I prepare and I know what I'm doing in this situation, I have everything at my hands, I have the checkbox and advisor with me. There are also special advisors like this one for power shortages. I'm living next to a processing plant for oil, so I want to have information on emergencies that might happen there. Also, there is a lot more information from the BBK, especially on the NENA app.
Spoiler, ja, ab und zu passiert.
And yes, I might do a sniffing test if it's smelling for chemicals, but you might also get the information over your app, which might be a bit more convenient, and it will tell you which areas are actually impaired by the situation. There are different channels you can get this information from, which might be quite interesting. So, but one warning, don't use one source exclusively, because in case of a power shortage, internet might go down, so you want to have in the end some backup. So if we as a society, when we as a society together would like to be in the situation where we can adapt to each situation, then have such a checklist. This checklist also help you to help each other, so that not on the day X when something happens and THV is standing there with food, you should expect this. Maybe you would need to have stocks for one day. So please be prepared.
Mündig und selbstständig zu sein mit einer kleinen Hilfe zur Selbsthilfe, indem ich sage, ich habe hier jetzt ein bisschen, ja,
so, make sure to be prepared, so should be more generous with your supplies, food supplies. And if all of that is prepared, then you can also support the emergency services. This will help to get the situation under control a bit. This is just a few details, but they can have a big impact, great effect. And if everyone takes care of these,
und zwar überregional oder vielleicht sogar
especially in a situation that is affecting more than one region or the entire country.
Okay, cool, mache ich jetzt auch mal und pack mir
so
ein paar Sachen auf Seite.
The plan would be to have all of this prepared.
Juck ich mich noch mal im Ohr und danke.
Yeah, make sure you prepare and thanks a lot. So.
Alles in einer Packung muss man nur warm machen. Ein Spaß. Vielen, vielen Dank.
So, sorry, there was a bit of a break.
Aus diesem Internet jede Menge
there are a lot of questions.
Und damit würde ich direkt mal anfangen.
Let's start with those questions. The first question is.
Die erste Frage ist. Bisher so, sind die Empfehlungen eher
the recommendations
für
are for like small
für die
survival cells, like families. So how about the larger neighborhood? How can I prevent my hunting neighbor from grabbing my supplies? Yes, this is an important topic, so you can try and motivate. Your neighbor to also set up these supplies. Of course, it's nice if you not only take care of yourself, but also motivate other people to do the same. And you can also then maybe have a barbecue if you have a barbecue at home with your hunting neighbor.
Eine Waffe hat, euch auch eine Waffe zu.
So what is bad to get a gun if someone else has a gun?
Ja, ich hab noch eine kleine
little addition.
Dazu. Und zwar ist es durchaus auch psychologisch bei solchen Situationen
there is some psychological research on this topic that in such a situation it's not the case that everyone becomes a lonely wolf and only looks after himself. On the contrary, in such a situation we are social, even though some people have disabilities in this area are not quite as good. And we take care of each other. We are social animals. We look after each other. It's more likely that people are helping each other instead of fighting each other. So one example, I had no electricity in our house for 8 hours. And this took a while. There was no internet, no electricity. All the neighbors went outside and were talking to each other and they were checking to see if anyone would need help. So it's not the case that people step outside and they're
ganz ehrlich, der hat immer was mit.
Kill each other with their guns.
Okay, danke für die Erklärung. Dann gibt es eine Frage zu den.
Then there's a question for the emergency documents. Should these be originals or the copies?
Also je nachdem, wie man das
so
gestalten kann.
Gut ist natürlich,
wenn man die Originale tagtäglich braucht.
Of course, it's good if you have the originals that you need every day with you. And it's best if you have copies of the other documents in a separate place. I mean, it could happen any day that you lose your purse, and then it's good to have these documents somewhere else as a copy. Important documents, you can get a notarized copy, but any copy is better than nothing.
Also grundsätzlich
So something is better than nothing in general. For instance, you might have something at your parents' place, your children's place, or wherever. And if you have a copy stored there, this copy is better than nothing.
Thank you. Nächste Frage oder kam noch was aus dem Ja, okay.
Dann next question.
Die nächste Frage aus dem Internet ist, gibt es irgendwo eine Liste mit gesammelten
Is there a list somewhere with products, supplies that could be recommended?
Von vielen Leuten.
Yes, there are many lists like this by many different people. And different people have different opinions. So just as an example, this is a camping stove, which is added to the attached to the gas container.
Wenn man jetzt sich darauf vorbereitet, dass man zu Hause vorbereiten möchte, dann nimmt man ein Produkt, das tiefer ist. Dieser hier
so this one can be made quite small. You can detach the gas stove bit.
Unstabil ist er auch.
And the nice thing is, you can easily carry this one around. But this is probably not suitable for cooking at home.
Wir können aber gerne noch mal mehr zu machen.
This way, different products have different areas where they can be used more easily. So this one you wouldn't use at home, but for going outside. Another question. Is there a checklist for all the things mentioned in this talk? So not only the BBK list. So we've been following the BBK very closely. Intentionally, what made me wonder quite a bit is that a while ago that this particular federal agency is creating some kind of advice for how to stock up things, and this apparently there was a discussion about this, but this list needs to be adapted anyway for your particular case, so that it makes sense for you, for what you have, and for your space. One more comment on this. So I was talking about protection a lot. Everything I was mentioning is also on the list, but ordered differently. So I've just reordered this group differently based on what the items protect against. The next question. Which apps can you recommend, especially considering that there might be no internet, so they need to be able to work offline? So I personally find it's important to have a map, geocaching app, which is stored offline, for instance. Yeah, this could be a separate talk, so we're running out of time. There's another very important question. So where do I get my pizza from?
Ja, bei Milliways.
Genau, also im Kids Village oder bei Milliways da.
So yeah, where do I get my pizza? From Milliways or the Kids Space? But yeah, we had an oven from the fire brigade. But in any ways, you have to build something together, and then you get a nice result. As a short remark, it's really easy to make a pizza. You just need a bit of flour and water. Then a barbecue grill or something. Tomato you can have in a glass or in a can. Corn or bacon you get also very easy. If you really want to, you can make this on your own, very simple. And the multi-opener we've seen once, you can open basically everything, and if you have a bit of camping experience, you get a very decent meal. Okay, so thank you very much to everyone. To all the listeners and viewers, please stay healthy. And then for everyone who hasn't seen it on the fly when we showed it, this is the homepage from BBK. And here under preparation, you find the information we talked about, which actually might be interesting for the Germans. So, here are all the things at one place. Okay, thank you.